that is about the difference of sign. So this video mainly will be based on the difference of sign. So which we have done till the Venn diagram so far, correct? No? So this one we have also. So little more about Venn diagram will come to know in this video. First thing I'll tell you about is how to draw a Venn diagram for A intersection C. Any two sets they are given. Okay, let's assume any two sets are given. Now B union C is nothing but all the elements contained in B and C together. So what I will do is I will name any of these things like A, B, C. These three circles need not be of the same size or whatever. They can be of different size. So in that, I am drawing the circles in that way. Then after that, I am going to check which is it, this one, B union C, which means all the elements present in B as well as all the elements present in C. Correct? So I am going to shape this complete portion. Including the some portions of A as well. I just have to include the B circle as well as the C circle. That is B union C. Yeah? And that is how you are going to represent A union C using a Venn diagram. And similarly, let's move on to the next one. This one, A intersection B union C it is. Okay? So I will name these as A, B, and C. So first, let me go for B union C. Okay, I'll look into what is done in the bracket. We know always in mathematics, first we look into the bracket terms. So B union C is completely full. Correct? Let me not shade it yet. Imagine this is completely shaded. But I just want what that is common with A. Which is the portion of B union C that is common with A? That is nothing but just this. Exactly. Correct or not? Which means in this full portion, the one which is common to A is just this. I am just going to erase the other shading part, and this is the answer for A intersection B. Yeah, intersection means whichever is included in that. So this one is the only part which is included with A. So B union C, first you think it is shaded completely, then you erase all the other part. Only the ones which remains as A, and that is nothing but A intersection B union C. Yeah. So this is the idea. The other one, this is much easier if you erase this one with this. A and B and C. I don't even have to look into the C. So A intersection B means the portion of the circles which is common to A and B. I just can't see this. So yeah. So just the portion which is common to A and B is nothing but A intersection B. Okay. So with this, I hope you can try these two things. Okay. Pause the video and you can quickly try this out and let me know how it is. Okay. In this one, we can see the first diagram looks something like this. I quickly draw this. I will be A, B, C itself. Okay, suppose this is A, this is B, and this is C. So if I am looking for only A intersection C, this one, A intersection C, so the portion which is common is only this. This one, right? So A and C is here. In case the C was here, then it would be same to as this one. But since I am drawing the C over here, I am just looking at the portion which is common to A and C. So A and C, the portion common is only this. And this is the diagram for A intersection C. And this particular thing has nothing to do with B. Yeah. So this is the one. Then the other one, B, the fifth one. You can check the diagram, the Venn diagram is going to look something like this. Okay. So this is A, B, C. And A intersection B I needed. Okay, A intersection B is this portion and A intersection C is this portion. Okay? And both are the union, which means together, they are required both together. So which means the total finally shaded portion will be this. Yeah? So with this, I can conclude that these both are equal to each other. That is, A intersection B union of C is equal to A intersection B union A intersection C. And that is the property which we have from which we have studied, that is the distributive property of intersection, correct? No? So using the Venn diagram also, I can prove that these properties are true. So they can ask me certain things saying that the proof using Venn diagrams that this particular thing is equal to this one. So you just have to draw a random Venn diagram and just prove that the two diagrams, the shaded portion is exactly the same. Clear? So you just have to write it properly and draw these things. So that's how you can. So this is probably almost all about the Venn diagram. So then we move on to the important topic, that is difference of sets. Okay? So this is a very important topic for you all because there is a lot of confusion even at the end stage. So a lot of confusion you will have, what is this A minus B and what is this B minus A? So it will be a huge confusion. So listen carefully what I'm writing. Okay? So when I'm writing difference of set, obviously one set minus the other set. Clear? One set minus the other set. That doesn't mean that all the elements are subtracting. No, it has nothing to do with the subtraction. It just has to do with something taking away the elements from one set to another. Okay? So I'll do it with the help of an example that will make clear things. Let me assume that A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and B is 2, 4, 6, 8. Clear? And then trying to find out what is A minus B and B minus A. So first I will look into A minus B. So the meaning of A minus B is simply nothing but from the A set taking away the B set. Okay? Removing all the elements of B from A is nothing but A minus B. Clear? So you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, A set is there. Keep it as standard. Now slowly look into B set and remove those elements from A set. 1 is there in B, it is not there. So I write it in B minus B. Okay? 2 is there here and B also it is there. I take that 2 away because since I have to subtract, it should take away the elements of B from A. So 2 is removed out. And I will not write that. 3, it's not there, so I will write it. 4 is there, so I will not write it. 5 is not there, I will write it. 6 is there, I will not write it. And 8 has nothing to do with A. So A is my standard element when it comes to A minus B. Okay, A is the parent from which B is removed out when it is A minus B. So this is the answer for A minus B. Now, suppose if I look into B minus B. Suppose if it is B minus B. Now I have to mainly concentrate on B dots. B is the standard set. Clear? B is the standard set. From B set, I have to remove the 8 elements of B. So, I will look into B, that is 2, it is there in this one as well. 4 is also there in the A set. 6 is also there in the A set. But only... Okay, so we are learning about the difference of set in which I told you all to find out what is A minus B from the A set, taking A as the standard set. I will take out all the elements of B from A. Okay? So the element present in B is 2, 4, 6, 8. So I will take away the 2. I will print off. 4 is taken out and 6 is taken out. 8 is there in B but nothing to do with A. So the only elements present in A is 1, 3 and 5. I will just write it. And that is nothing but A minus B. Clear? So do not confuse it with B minus A. So now B minus A means I just have to keep all the elements of A as it is. That means I am going to look the B as the standard element. From B, I am removing all the elements present in A. Clear? So from all the elements present in A is 1 is 2. Cancel it out. It's already present here. Then 4 is also present. 6 is also present. But 8 is not present in A. So which means the only element which is going to stay is 8. Clear? So that is nothing but B minus A. So from here I can come to conclusion saying that A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Yes? So which means these two sets have nothing in common, will never have something in common. So this is the meaning of A. This means that the two sets will not have anything in common. So to draw a Venn diagram also, I can give you an idea saying that A minus B. Let me take the two Venn diagrams here, A and B. So suppose from A I am removing all the elements of B, which means this circle has to be completely taken away from A. So only remaining things to shade will be from here, that is this particular portion of the circle for A. So this is the Venn diagram for A minus B. Similarly, I can do the diagram for B minus A. So this is A and this is B. Just the remaining portion of B, except that of the A circle. A circle is completely left out, only the B circle is shaded. And this is the Venn diagram for A minus B and B minus A. And there is one small topic which is pending, that is about the disjoint set. So the two sets are called as disjoint sets if they have nothing in common. Okay? So if they have nothing in common, such type of set are called as disjoint sets. For example, I can tell these two sets. These two sets have nothing in common, therefore I can easily call them as disjoint sets. So I can write in some way, suppose I draw the red diagram for this one. So these two diagrams are completely separated. That means A and B have nothing in common. So there is no intersection between the two circles of A and B. So that is why it is called as a disjoint set. And also, if they ask you how can you prove that two sets are disjoint, what will I do is I will simply find the intersection of two sets. That should contain no elements in it, which means null set. We can represent it as this one or this one. So A intersection B, I find out that it is a null set, then such type of a set are called as disjoint sets. So there is nothing common between the two sets. Such type of sets are called as disjoint sets. So we move on to the next topic. So the next topic in this chapter is going to be a complement of set. In a complement of set, complement, I don't know whether you have heard before or not. Have you heard about the word complement before? Yes, complement means not the English word complement, something like from one thing, the opposite of it. The opposite of something is called as a complement of that. Okay? Not exactly the meaning of opposite. Just imagine that it's something like an opposite. Okay? So this complement and difference of set have a lot of relation. So that is how, what will I do is I take an example and explain what is a complement of a set. So here you can see the complement for one thing you should remember is to find out the complement of a set. Universal set is a must. Okay? Universal set, I hope you remember what it is. It is the set from where all the other sets are taken up. Correct? So that's why to find out the complement of a given set, from where we are taking up that particular set, that is universal set, is a must. So whenever they are asking about complement of a set, look for the universal set. Okay? It will be given. So then you see, imagine the universal set is given to me as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And one set is given to me as 2, 4, 6. Random numbers is given to them. And they are asking me to find out the complement of that given set. So it is simply A complement. It is written like this, okay? A dash. You call it as A complement. So that thing is nothing but I am subtracting the A elements, that is the elements present in A, from the universal set. Okay? A complement is nothing but the universal set minus the set A. So which means I am taking away all the elements present in universal set, I mean presented A from the universal set. So look into this. One is not present in A, so I will not cancel. I will remain. Two is there, I'll cancel it out. Three is not there, but I'll write it. Four is not there, I'll cancel it out. So then five is not there, B. Six. So this is the complement of a given set. That means I'm just subtracting the elements or removing the elements from the universal set. That given set. So that remaining elements other than those set numbers is called as a complement of a set. Clear? So that is very important for you to understand the difference between the difference of a set and the complement of a set. Complement of a set is a set nothing but removed from the universal set. Difference of two sets is subtracting within each other. It has nothing to do with the universal set. Okay? So the one example I saw which will help your understanding much better if we. So let's take an example, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 itself, and A is given to me as 2 empty and B is given to me as 3, 4, 5. Okay? So let's solve this. What is A complement? A complement is once you always make the habit of writing this particular formula, universal set minus 1. Clear? So make this habit of writing A complement is nothing but universal set minus A. So universal set minus A is how much? Just remove all the elements of, that is 2 and 3 only. Remove this off, but the remaining elements will be 1, 4, 5, 6. And this is my A complement. Clear? So this is the A complement, which means all the elements present in A is taken off from universal set, that is A complement. Next, moving on to B complement. Simple as that. U minus that is universal set minus A, universal set minus B, sorry. From this one, 3, 4, 5 should be taken. 3, 4, 5 should be taken. The remaining elements will be 1, 2, 6. Yes? So this is my B complement, which means all the elements of B is taken from universal set. So what about the next two? So the third one, they are asking us is to do the A intersection B, A complement intersection B complement. So this two I have already found out. Right? So just see which is the common element present in these two. 1 and 1 is present, yes, I write it. 2 is not there, 4 is not there, 5 is not there, 6 is there. Yeah? So I hope you have remembered what I told you. I have first make a habit of substituting all the numbers in this and then solving. I am just solving this directly. You all do it in a proper method, stepwise. Okay? So that is the one thing. So then after this, this I understood this one and 6. Let me find out this one. That is the fourth one. A union B, the whole complement. So for that I need to find out what is A union B first. Let me find out A union B here. The elements present in A and B combined together. That is 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay? A union B is elements present in these both combined together. 2, 3, 4, 5 is the A union B. Now I should find out what is the complement of it. Which means universe present minus A union B. This set, whatever the numbers present in this one, has to be removed from universal set. That is 2, 3, 4, 5 is removed. So what will remain? 1 like this. Right? So this one, A union B, the whole complement will remain as 1 and 6. That is also the same thing as that of A intersection. Yes, sorry, A complement intersection, B complement. From this I can conclude that A intersection, A complement intersection B complement is same as that of A union B, the whole complement. And that's what we come into the properties. So this is the end of this particular problem. And with the end of this one, we have to note which is about the properties of the complement of a set. So this, what I want you to do is take a random example for AB. Okay, AB and universal set was obviously me. Take a universal set random. A you take and B you take. Suppose if there is C anywhere, no, that's not there anymore. No. So A, B and universal set. Take your numbers or letters or anything of your own choice. And verify these properties. I tell you what these properties are, explain it. If at all I take a complement of a set and again complement it. Understood? Complement of a set 1. And again if I complement it, which means that number set only, I subtract it again with the universal set. I'll get back the set itself. Yes? Try it out and see. If in case you have no doubts in this, I'll solve all these and let you know in the next video. For now, you try it on your own example and check it. So now, another one. A union of intersection or complement of A will always lead you to universal set. Clear? That means all the elements which is present in A. A complement is nothing but the elements not present in A. When I'm combining here, obviously it will return back to universal set. So now intersection if I go, it will be always null set. Nothing is present in those set. Correct? So in another way, they can ask that complement of a set and the intersection of its own is always a disjoint set. Correct? Which means those two will have nothing in common. So then, next we have about these two laws, which I just proved right now. So this one I have proved with this example. Like that, easily you can prove this particular thing also. And these two are called as De Morgan's law. Okay? De Morgan's law. And this finds a lot of application in digital electronics. That is the electronics which are phones, all these things, devices which you have in your digital electronics, the logic boards, everything. So these finds a lot of application. These two laws of complements find a lot of application in this one. So that's why I want you all to remember this name. Some random day you will have that topic. That time it will be a flash. Okay? So just remember these two laws are called as De Morgan's law. And this in sentence wise, if I have to tell, the union, the complement of union of any two sets is same as that of intersection of individual complements. Yes? Understood? So that is what this De Morgan told. Actually, that is what we told. I can tell it another second law is nothing but the intersection of the complement of intersection of the two sets is same as the union of individual complements. Here, I want you all to write this sentence what I told as well. Okay, it might not be there in your textbook, but I want you all to write it. It will be helpful in the physics as well as in the next coming chapters, especially in next year. year we are going to study about vectors, even that is will be helpful. So remember the word De Morgan and this two sentences of De Morgan's law. Then the other one, next one, the complement of null set will always be a universal set, and the complement of universal set will always be a null set. It's very simple, you can check it out with your example and see. And this, these two things can be highly asked in competitive exams. So any exams you see, they can ask what is the complement of a null set. Complement of a null set, and you'll be stuck. And suddenly to think of an example and then solve, it will take a lot of time. So you have to think, complement of a null set is nothing but universal set. Complement of a universal set is nothing but null set. Simple as that. Okay? So I hope you all will do an example related to this one and all the proof, that all the properties I want you to prove. And if you have still doubt, then clear it out in the next video. Okay? Thank you. So with this, you can complete the next exercise, that is 1.5, right? 1.4 is done, I mean 1.4 few problems are remaining last as well, which is of the difference of set. Including that, you can complete the next exercise related to complement of set, that is 1.5. So finish that up and send me the pictures of those notes. We'll move on with the last topic of this chapter.